English translation. And normally I have multiple color markers, but I don't have any today, so you just have to do it. Alright. So we have messenger RNA. The 5' end has a 3' end. So this is messenger RNA. You have your codon, which is made of three letters. So the first codon is usually AUG. And we're going to just make up other codons. Does anybody have their codon chart? Which, can I use this slide? So I might use this codon chart in a minute. How about that? Okay. Okay. Alright, so we're just going to make up a couple of codons here. Not on the messenger RNA, okay? So that is just for me, okay? So keep that in mind. Amino acids are not on RNA, okay? This is the RNA molecule, okay? That's not double stranded. All right, so we're just, because I don't want you guys getting confused, because sometimes with my drawings aren't ideal, you guys go back and look at them, and then you can see yourself. So this is the RNA molecule, right? And it has these letters on it. Guys with me?
Mm-hmm.
And it tangles in it, right? These amino acids don't have anything to do with it. They're just a note for me. Now, the ribosome has two subunits, a large and a small. It's going to sit down. Okay. Now, there are two binding sites on the ribosome, okay? And the video said the A and the P site. I don't actually care that much that you know A and the P site, because I can't remember which ones do, okay? But I want you to know there are two sites on the ribosome, and those two sites are where the tRNA molecule bind, okay? Can you guys remember that? The A and the P sites are sites where the transfer RNA molecule binds. So sitting in the ribosome, or on the ribosome, we have two, there's enough space for two tRNA molecules. We're good? So there's one. Here's the second one. And your drawings kind of suck. Alright, now, this tRNA molecule, what is the anticodon of this one? Complementary base pairing. UAC. Right? Now, it turns out the enzymes that add the amino acid to the tRNA molecule know what amino acid to add by looking at the anticodon. So on all tRNAs that have a UAC and the thiamine is on that end. Does that make sense? So whenever you put the UAC anticodon and the thiamine is put on that tRNA. Now what would be the anticodon to this tRNA molecule? AAA. Whenever there's an AAA anticodon on the tRNA, the enzymes in the cell know to add the phenylalanine. So I need you to know, for translation, you have to have an mRNA molecule with codons. You start with an AUG codon, right? That's on the five-ton end of the messenger RNA. You have to have the full ribosome. The ribosome sits on the messenger RNA. Sitting on the ribosome and on the messenger RNA are two DNA molecules. Okay? So they're all sitting together. That's good?
Mm-hmm.
Now, the ribosome does the chemistry to move this amino acid here and to create a peptide bond. Okay? So, see, all of the ribosome is the chemistry to move this and find that amino acid. So it's been moved, so it's not here anymore. So now, two amino acids have gone. This tRNA is useless. So it goes away. Some of your books are going to show an AP and an E site. That E site is the exit site, basically saying tRNA is moved. I tend to be more the exit site. Now, the ribosome moves in this direction because it goes to the peptide. So the ribosome moves. It only has space so that it can basically hold really two tRNA. This one or not, right? Now, a new tRNA molecule. Okay. What would be the anticodon for this tRNA molecule?
CAC.
Or any tRNA that has a CAC, there's a valine amino acid attached to it. That's good? Now, this ribosome can do the chemistry to move both of these amino acids here. It'll actually cut it off of here and move it up here. You see how that joins? This gets moved through to there. This doesn't exist here anymore. You guys good? So we went from one amino acid, now we've built up to three. The ribosome keeps moving. The ribosome keeps moving. That tRNA goes away. Okay. I'm not going to draw it right now, but I'll just put an arrow. A new tRNA molecule comes in because it's space codon, right? Space codon, the anticodon of the next tRNA molecule. Space codon is just a codon. What would be the anticodon of this tRNA molecule?
CUC.
Whenever there's a CUC on the anticodon, the amino acid gives you an acid. Space codon, and that's the word. Now the enzymes or the chemistry of the ribosome. We'll move this one a minute over here. That's good.
Okay.
That codon part you always begin with. Now, these amino acids don't mean much to you, only if you take a biochemistry course, older people are going to make you learn the structures of them. It's too much to ask. And so, instead of writing the thymine with theonyl and phenylalanine and valine, you use these three other things. But as long as you're getting the idea, that's what you want. Ribosome keeps moving. This one exits. The ribosome comes here. There is no RNA that's been moved. And the video showed a release factor. It turns out a lot of the stuff is more complicated. We're giving you the bare bones of it. Okay. But basically, you get here, this is your signal that now everything just comes apart. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
So, and the protein, the ribosome comes off. The messenger RNA gets separated because none of these things are covalently bound to each other except for the amino acids. And then if you're that, that the protein will dissociate from the tRNA. So you'll end up with the tRNA floating around and you'll end up with this protein. And then it will fold into proper precursors. And most genes have about 400 codons. Of course, we've only done four of them, but they're going to have 400, so we end up with roughly 400 amino acid protein that folds in this proper chain. You guys comfortable with this?